Welcome back to The Daily Poem here on the Close Reads Podcast Network. I'm David Kern, and today is Friday, June 5th, 2020. Today's poem is by Nikki Giovanni, an American poet who was born in 1943. She is a commentator, activist, and has won numerous awards, including the Langston Hughes Medal and the NAACP Image Award. She's highly decorated, quite popular, certainly one of the best known of all African-American poets. And the poem that I'm going to read today is called Rosa Parks. As I said yesterday, given the circumstances in our country right now, given the tragic events that led to the protests all across the country, I wanted to share some poems. Some well-known poems, in many cases, by some of our most highly regarded African-American poets. And so today, I did want to share this one from Nikki Giovanni. It's called Rosa Parks. It's a bit of a narrative poem, a prose poem. But I'll read it just the one time, and then that'll be it. I'm going to keep my comments to a minimum this week. So this is Rosa Parks by Nikki Giovanni. This is for the Pullman porters who organized when people said they couldn't and carried the Pittsburgh Courier and the Chicago Defender to the black Americans in the South so they would know they were not alone. This is for the Pullman porters who helped Thurgood Marshall go South and come back North to fight the fight that resulted in Brown versus Board of Education, because even though Kansas is West, and even though Topeka is the birthplace of Gwendolyn Brooks, who wrote the powerful The Chicago Defender Sends a Man to Little Rock, it was the Pullman porters who whispered to the traveling men, both the blues men and the race men, so that they would both know what was going on. This is for the Pullman porters, who smiled as if they were happy and laughed like they were tickled when some folks were around, and who silently rejoiced in 1954 when the Supreme Court announced its 9-0 decision that separate is inherently unequal. This is for the Pullman porters who smiled and welcomed a 14-year-old boy onto their train in 1955. They noticed his slight limp that he tried to disguise with a doo-wop walk. They noticed his stutter and probably understood why his mother wanted him out of Chicago during the summer when school was out. 14-year-old black boys with limps and stutters are apt to try to prove themselves in dangerous ways when mothers aren't around to look after them. So this is for the Pullman porters who looked over that 14-year-old while the train rolled the reverse of the blues highway from Chicago to St. Louis to Memphis to Mississippi. This is for the men who kept him safe. And if Emmett Till had been able to stay on a train all summer, he would have grown maybe a bit of a paunch, certainly lost his hair, probably have worn bifocals and bounced his grandchildren on his knee telling them about his summer riding the rails. But he had to get off the train and ended up in Money, Mississippi, and was horribly, brutally, inexcusably, and unacceptably murdered. This is for the Pullman porters who, when the sheriff was trying to get the body secretly buried, got Emmett's body on the northbound train, got his body home to Chicago, where his mother said, "I want the world to see what they did to my boy." And this is for all the mothers who cried. And this is for all the people who said, "Never again." And this is about Rosa Parks, whose feet were not so tired. It had been, after all, an ordinary day until the bus driver gave her the opportunity to make history. This is about Mrs. Rosa Parks from Tuskegee, Alabama, who was also the field secretary of the NAACP. This is about the moment Rosa Parks shouldered her cross, put her worldly goods aside, was willing to sacrifice her life so that the young man in Money, Mississippi, who had been so well protected by the Pullman porters, would not have died in vain. When Mrs. Parks said no, a passionate movement was begun. No longer would there be a reliance on the law. There was a higher law. When Mrs. Parks brought that light of hers to expose the evil of the system, the sun came and rested on her shoulders, bringing the heat and the light of truth. Others would follow Mrs. Parks. Four young men in Greensboro, North Carolina, would also say no. Great voices would be raised, singing the praises of God and exhorting us to forgive those who trespass against us. But it was the Pullman porters who safely got Emmett to his granduncle, and it was Mrs. Rosa Parks who could not stand that death. And in not being able to stand it, she sat back down. This has been the Daily Poem. Thanks so much for listening, and I'll be back on Monday with another poem for you.